Good evening, everybody. Thanks for coming online. Bless you. Shkadosh, Kadahaya Gagalosh. I don't know why the coming in is not showing. God bless you all. God bless you all. Share the video. Tag somebody. I lost your line. I is the man save Patiri. Tag somebody, okay? Yo, you do me, yo. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. God bless you all. God bless you all for coming. Thank you very much for joining me this evening. We are not going to wait anymore, so we are going to go straight to business. We have been looking out since a Sunday and a Tuesday. We have been looking at how is a man saved. Praise God. What gospel, what kind of gospel should a man hear that will bring about salvation? You know, what kind of gospel that should a man hear that will bring about salvation? Is it any kind of message that bring about salvation? What kind of message should a man hear and should a man believe that will make him to know that he has salvation? For instance, if I just come now, I said, I preached about myself and I said, come and give your life to Jesus. You know, you didn't hear about Jesus. It was me you hear about. So that kind of salvation is not genuine. Glory to God. So today we are going to be seeing that part three of that message, of this message, you know. In our previous Evangelist Sunday, those, thanks for joining. God bless you, man. God bless you. God bless you all. I don't know, if the network is not too strong today. The people coming online, it's not really showing. So you can please do me a favor by commenting so that I can know that you are online. Okay, God bless you all for joining. But I'm just going to be talking by feet because I believe you are all there. Now we're looking at I is a massive. So in our previous topic or discussion, which we saw the book of Romans. You know, when we look at the book of Romans, and we see that a man is only saved when he hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ. And we will still go there today again. But before we go there, I want to take us back to the book of John 3. The book of John 3, you know, the book of John 3, there's something that happened there that after Jesus Christ, in chapter 2 of John, Jesus Christ did a lot of miracle. He turned water to wine, you know. After he turned water to wine, then there was a man that came to Jesus by night. Now let's see what happened in that John chapter 3. Let's go there briefly. So I just want you to stay with me, okay? And share the video, tag somebody to call me. How is a man saved? Now, in verse 3, remember in chapter 2, Jesus Christ had done miracle, turned water to wine. That is to say, even miracle is good. I believe in miracle. Praise God. That is why even after this meeting tonight, I'm going to be praying for you, and I believe miracle will be given to you if you are sick, but you are going to be healed, even while I'm ministry. But one, I want you to know that miracle is not salvation. Healing is not salvation. Pastor Mike, thanks for joining. If you are just coming, just comment or like the video so that I will know that you are joining me. But most of the people joining me is not showing. Okay, Pastor Mike, you're showing now. So thanks for joining, Pastor Mike. You know, so like I was saying, miracle is not salvation. I believe in miracle. Praise God. You know why? I believe in Jesus, so I believe in miracle. I do miracle. Every believer does miracle. We believe in miracle. But my point here is that miracle is not salvation. Healing is not salvation. You see, you know, I've seen a lot of believers. I ask them, how were you born again? You say, you know, I was sick and they took me to the church. The pastor prayed for me. You know, the pastor prayed for me. When the pastor prayed for me, I became me. So that was how I become born again. Praise God. The truth is that healing is not born again. A man can be healed and he's not born again. Let me shock you. A man can even do miracles and he's not born again. Because even if you go to the four gospel, in the book of Matthew, in the book of John, Luke, and Mark, you see the apostles, they were not apostles yet, they were still disciples of Jesus. They did miracle. Your Christ sent them forth, they cast out devils, they did miracle. Do you know why? Because your Christ gave them the authority to do miracle in his name. Good name, sir. You know? So, but then they were not still born again. They became born again after Jesus Christ resurrected from the dead. Though they believe that Jesus Christ is the one that is going to take away the sins of the world. Praise God. They believe that he's the Messiah. They believe that. In fact, it was only Peter that would even believe that. The other people, they were looking at Jesus as a natural king. You know, as a natural king. That was why even Herod was fighting against Jesus. Because he thought that when that king has come, that was going to overthrow him. But he didn't know that the king that has come is the king of salvation. Praise God. He's the king that has come to give us eternal life. You can see now. So healing is not salvation. Maybe you were sick, you got healed, you have been looking for the fruit of the womb, they give fruit of the womb, or miracles, any kind of miracles, they are not salvation. Glory to God. Miracles are not salvation. Though we do those things, praise God, but they are not salvation. So whenever you mistake, say, because I was having one issue or the other, so I went to church, and when the pastor prayed for me, that problem was solved. So because of that, I am not saved. No, that is not how a man is saved. For a man to be saved, they have to be the hearing of Jesus. They have to be the preaching of Jesus. You get what I'm saying now? They have to be the preaching of Jesus for a man to be saved. So look at this. Like I said just now, in that chapter 2, excuse me. Excuse me. Yeah. Now, in that chapter 2, you know, I'm not too used to sitting down preaching. I like standing, but because of the video, so we just have to sit down, you know what I'm saying? Now, in that chapter 2, we say that Jesus Christ have done a lot of miracles, healed the sick, evil tongue water to wine. Praise God, and we still do those things today in the name of Jesus. Now, in chapter 3, the Bible says, after he have done those miracles, there was a man that came to him. The Bible called the man Nicodemus. That was the man came to Jesus by night. You know, there are people that still do those things today. There are a lot of people that believe in your ministry, but they will not honor you publicly. But they will always come to you in the secret. Like come to you in the Facebook Messenger. It's all right. But what is most important that he came. And said, this man came to Jesus by night. And the Bible said this man was a Pharisee. He was a Pharisee. And he said he was a ruler of the Jews. That is to say, this man was a religious leader. We can say he was even a pastor of the Jews. Praise God. Was a religious leader. He knows the Bible. He can quote the Bible, the Old Testament. So for the fact that you were born in church, does not even mean that you are born again. Or for the fact that your pastor is your father is a pastor, your mother is a pastor, does not mean that you are born like I have children now. Praise God. Because they are, I have children, because I'm a pastor, I have children now. That doesn't mean that you are born again. For them to be born again, I have to preach the gospel to them. And they will believe that gospel. That is what brings about salvation. You understand now? So Nicodemus came to Jesus and he said, Master, we know that thou art a teacher from God. For no man can do this miracle that thou doest except God be with him. Glory to God. And there's something we can learn here also. Because God was with Jesus, he recognized those miracles. And today, God is not just with us, God is in us. So that is why we do miracles too. Let me leave that. Now look at what Jesus Christ told Nicodemus. Nicodemus said, forget about the miracle, forget about all those things. Look at what is important here now. He said, Jesus answered and said unto him, verily, verily, I say unto thee, except a man is born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. He cannot see the kingdom of God except a man is born again. He will do what? He cannot see the kingdom of God. He said, forget about the miracle. That was the same thing Jesus Christ told his disciples. After they went out preaching, they came back. They was happy. They said, Master, even though the demons are subject to us in thy name. Jesus Christ said, don't rejoice because demons are subject to your name. So don't rejoice about that. Say, rejoice because your name is written in the book of life. Rejoice because you have eternal life. That is what you should rejoice about. When I see Christians that are sad, you know why they are sad? It's because they are too materialistic. When a believer is sad because he is too materialistic. See, a born again man should not have any reason to be sad. A born again man that know what it means to be born again. It is one thing to be born again. It's another thing to know what it means to be born again. A born again man that knows what it means to be born again should not have any reason to be sad. You know why? Because the joy of the Lord is our strength. Because that was the same thing David was begging for in the Old Testament. Say, restore to me the joy of my salvation, because he was not having it. He was not having the Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost was not living it then. But in the new birth, we now have the indwelling of the Holy Ghost. And people say that indwelling of the Holy Ghost is our joy, is our strength. You see that now? So that's why you can see in a born again man, he may not have a car, he may not have a house, he may not have money in his pocket, but he's happy. You know why? Because the dread of the Lord is the dread of the believer. Praise God. Eternal life is the dread of the believer. Glory to God. Thank God for what you have. Thank God for all those things. Praise God. But the truth is that no matter what you have, they can never make you to have joy. The only thing that can give you joy is eternal life. Praise God. So when you see a man, a born again man that is happy, it's because that born again man knows where he's happy. Sometimes people just say that we are happy, we are shouting, oh, glory to God, hallelujah. They just think that, oh, glory to God. See, let me tell you the truth. We are in this earth. Hallelujah. I am in this earth with you. You are in this earth with you. Every challenge people have gone through in this earth, because we are born again, that don't mean that we don't face the challenge people are facing through this earth. You face it. Praise God. But the truth is that, but because the joy of the Lord is our strength, that joy of the Lord is our strength, has made us an overcomer. Glory to God. Let me follow the way the Spirit of God is leading me today. Let me follow. I believe there are somebody that's going to hear this. Praise God. You know what the Bible says? The Bible says, you are of God. He said, you have God, little children. Say, for greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. Greater is he that is in you. So no matter what is happening in the world, praise God, greater is he that is in us. Hallelujah. So the one in us is greater. Is greater than our challenges. Is greater than everything. Is greater than Satan. Praise God. So because of that one that is greater that is in me, praise God, because of that one, I am always joyful. So you should not be sad. Praise God. You should not be sad. Because greater is he that is in you. Hallelujah. You see that now? So Nicodemus came to Jesus and was asking Jesus, he said, except a man be born again, He cannot see the kingdom of God. Now see what Jesus Christ said to Nicodemus. So see what Nicodemus said to Jesus. Nicodemus said unto him, how can a man be born when he is old? Can he enter the second time into his mother's womb and be born? Praise God. Even Nicodemus understand that thing, that when a man is old in the natural, he cannot go back to his mother's womb the second time and be born. Praise God. That is why a believer also, a born-again man, a believer, a man that is in Christ, cannot lose the salvation. Because you cannot go back to the womb of the womb of Jesus the second time and be born. Your God is not going to go back to the cross again and die for you. He has done it once and for all. There is no sacrifice. Glory to God. You need to hear that. Okay. Now look at what Jesus Christ said to Nicodemus. After he answered that question, he said, can I go back to my mother's womb and be born the second time? Look at what Jesus Christ said to him. Jesus Christ said, Jesus answered, verily I say unto you, except a man be born of water and of the Spirit. Let me explain that. When Jesus Christ said, except a man is born of the water and of the Spirit, he said, except a man is born of the water, which is the Spirit. Or except a man is born of the water, I am talking about the Spirit. He's not talking about baptism of water. Jesus Christ was using water. Because Nicodemus was a natural, he was a carnal man. So he was using water to describe the baptism of the Spirit to Nicodemus. Because water does not get people born again. Jesus, he was a figure of speech. You must understand that there are places in the scripture where the Bible was describing spiritual things with us with physical things. For instance, in the book of John, Jesus said on that great day, as the scripture has said, he that believe, he said, out of his belly shall flow rivers of living water. How can river flow? Let's assume that scripture is literal. How can river flow from your belly? No, he wasn't talking about natural water. Praise God. He was talking about the Holy Ghost. As the scripture has said, he that believe on me, out of his belly shall flow rivers of living water. He said this was what he was talking about, of the Holy Ghost that will come on them that believe. Praise God. So, except a man is born of the Spirit. Except a man is born of the Spirit. He was describing the Spirit with water. Because that is the best thing he can use to describe them. Hallelujah. Because we are spiritual people. Amen. Now look at the next line. Say, verily I say unto thee, except a man be born of water, and which is the Spirit, he cannot enter the kingdom of God. In other words, except a man is born of the Spirit, he cannot enter the kingdom of God. He was using water to describe the Spirit for Nicodemus. Hallelujah. Now look at the next line. You see that now. That's why you see the next line. We don't put water there again. What you see there is Spirit. That which is born of the flesh is flesh, and that which is born of the Spirit is Spirit. Hallelujah. Glory to God. See, that which is born of the flesh is flesh. That which is born of the Spirit is Spirit. You see that? That's why he didn't add water to it again. Now he didn't say that which is born of water and the Spirit is Spirit. No, that which is born of the Spirit is Spirit. See, I was telling them this evening in prayer meeting. I said, see, when we are still in this earth, even before rapture takes place, it's possible to live as a spirit. Praise God. You know what is hindering some of us is our mind, is our senses. Praise God. We think we know too much. We want to know more than God. But if we can do away with our senses, praise God, and we allow God to fill us with the knowledge of his will, praise God, we live as spirit on earth because we are spirits. That which is born of the Spirit is of the Spirit. That which is born of the of the flesh is of the flesh. And every born again man is born of the Spirit of God. If you are there, say, I am born of the Spirit of God. Every born again man is born of the Spirit of God. Praise God. So when you are born of the Spirit of God, automatically you become a spirit. Praise God. So what happened to fleshly people don't happen to the man of the Spirit. Praise God. The man of the Spirit does not know what is happening around him. Praise God. Because the man of the Spirit is a spiritual man. Praise God. Where others are crying, the man of the Spirit will not cry. Because he's a spirit. He knows what to do. Amen. Okay. Let's go to the next line. Now, he said, marvel not that I said unto you, ye must be born again. The wind bloweth where it listeth, and that heareth the sound thereof, but cannot tell where it cometh, and whither it goeth. So is everyone that is born
of the spirit. Remember, see that he said it's bring the spirit again. So he said everyone that is born of the spirit is not mentioning water again. So in that place, he was talking about the funniest thing is that people, the funniest thing is that the believers of today, they are too mentor of carnal things. For instance, when you go to the book of James, James said, is anyone sing among you who let it call the elders of the church, let the elders of the church, let it anoint it with oil, and the prayer of save, faith will eat the sick. Now the believers of the what they have done, they have left their faith and they hold oil. The emphasis of James there was the faith, not the oil. Oil does not bring healing. Oil, there is nothing in oil does not bring healing. It's the faith of the Son of God. The prayer of the faith of the Son of God will heal the sick. Praise God. See, it's time. You know, see, it's time again we should be spiritual conscious. Jesus Christ told that woman by that way. No, he told that woman. He said, the hour is now. We're true worshiper. We worship God in spirit. We're true worshiper. We worship God in what? In spirit and in truth. Praise God. Because let me just jump to that scripture. You see that now, it was talking about how to be born again. Now, you see that verse 15. Let's go to verse 15 now. Or let me just describe something from you in verse 14 of that same John 3. And Jesus Christ described it to Moses. He said, as Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness, even so must the Son of Man be lifted up. See, Jesus Christ now is explaining the scripture now to the Pharisee. The Bible calls him a Pharisee. He's a ruler of the Jews, he's a pastor, he's a member of the church. But yet, he did not know what it means to be born again. He did not know what it means to be born again. So Jesus Christ was now explaining the scripture to them. He said, as Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness. So that serpent that Moses lifted up in the wilderness was a pointer to Jesus. He was telling Nicodemus now. It was a pointer to Jesus. Praise God. Remember in the book of Numbers, you see the way the children of Israel, when they sin, the Bible says, and Moses made a bravest serpent. And anyone that is being bitten by that serpent will look unto the serpent and they will be healed. So today we don't look unto serpents. The writer of the Bible said, he said, looking unto Jesus, the author and the beginner of our faith. So Jesus Christ was now explaining the scripture to Nicodemus. Say, see, that serpent was pointing to me, that whosoever that will look unto me will be saved. As Moses lifted up the serpent, he said, watching you for the first time. God bless you. Oh, Peter, thanks for joining. I believe you will not regret for joining today. Praise God. You will not regret. See, so as Moses lifted up the serpent, as Moses laid up the serpent in the wilderness, even so must the Son of Man be lifted up. So has the Son of Man been lifted up? Yes, he has been lifted up. When he died on the cross, that was when the Son of Man was lifted up. So anyone who look unto the sacrifice of the Son of Man, why he said the Son of Man? Because he came to this earth as a man. Because it was man. Let me say this. It was man that sinned. Praise God. It was man that sinned. The problem of the world is sin. Hallelujah. Man has a solution to everything. Praise God. The other day, doctor was telling me, said, they who have medicine now for depression. You said now, so the problem, the common problem of man is sin. So that is why God has to come in the likeness of man. He didn't come as a God. He didn't come as God, not as a God, sorry. He came as man. And that is why anything Jesus Christ did while he was a man on earth, you can do it too. Praise God. You can do it too. Because Jesus Christ is our example. Is our prototype. Bible says he's the firstborn among many brethren. Praise God. Now listen to me. Let me quickly say this. Jesus Christ is no longer the only begotten Son of God. He was the only begotten Son of God then when he has not died. But the day he died and resurrected, he was no longer the only begotten Son of God. He is now the firstborn among many brethren. In other words, Jesus Christ is now our senior brother. So it's our present example. So whatsoever Jesus Christ did, we can do it. He healed the sick, we can heal the sick. He raised the dead, we can raise the dead. He cleansed the leper, we can cleanse the leper. Anything he can do, we can do it. You know why? Because we look unto him. He's our perfect example. Paul put it like this in the book of Galatians chapter 2, verse 20. He said, I am crucified with Christ. He said, right on, sir. Good evening, my senior sister. God bless you, man. He said, I am crucified with Christ. Nevertheless, I do what? I live. Yes, not I, but Christ live in me. He said, but now I am living by the faith. The word faith there means by the faithfulness of the Son of God who loves me and gave himself for me. By the faithfulness of the Son of God. So it's no longer about your faithfulness, because you can never be faithful enough. You can never be faithful enough. So what do I do now? When I want to live like Jesus, I look at his faithfulness, because his faithfulness is not the faithfulness of the born again man. His righteousness is not the righteousness of the born again man. His holiness is not the holiness of the born again man, because he's alive. He said, where Christ is alive. If I don't put it like this, he said, as he is, so are we in this world. He didn't say that is how we are going to be. No, he didn't. Immediately you became born again. Oh, glory to God. I feel they are not in this place now. Immediately you become born again, as he is. That is how the born again man becomes. You're not going to be like him. You are already like him. You're already like him. Now, you did not do anything to deserve it. No, you did not do anything to deserve it. Bible says, where we are now? Christ died for the ungodly. He all did it by himself. That is why the gospel is called the good news. Not just good news. The gospel is too good to be true. It's too good to be true. That is why it's difficult for people to believe it. We tell you that. You see, you don't have to do anything for you to be saved. You don't have to do anything before God will bless you. You don't have to do anything before you eat. All you just have to do, just believe that he has done it for you. Don't even look at yourself. Because when you look at yourself, now listen to me. When you look at yourself, you will see inferiority complex. When you look at yourself, you will say you are not educated. When you look at yourself, you will say, I cannot speak good grammar. Like I'm speaking bad grammar now. When you look at yourself, you said, I made a mistake yesterday. I made a mistake today. So you cannot be good enough. Hallelujah. That's when you look at yourself. Hallelujah. But glory be to God, the born again man is good enough. You know why? Because the born again man sees himself in Jesus. Hallelujah. So he sees himself in Jesus. So the life we now live in the flesh, we live by the faithfulness of the Son of God. Hallelujah. So that is why Jesus Christ told him, he said, he that is born of the Spirit is of the Spirit. He said, the wind blows wherever he like. He said, but so is every man that is born of the Spirit. No man can understand it. We are born of the Spirit of God. As he is, so are we in this world. Hallelujah. Say, you have God, little children, and you have overcome the world. For greater is he that is in you and he that is in this world. So how then is a man born again? A man is born again when he hears the gospel of Jesus. A man is not born again when he hears about 20 names of demon. Just imagine, you go to church on Sunday, what you'll be hearing, the 20 names of demon. You don't know one name of Jesus. Huh? You are hearing 20 names of demon. Praise God. Somebody will say, you know, the other day, somebody was looking, he said, the secret of demon. Hallelujah. I was laughing. I was telling him, what kind of message? He said, hey, this kind of message is good, because this kind of message, that is how you will not ask it to operate. Oh, I just shake my head. You know, there are some people you cannot argue with. You just shake your head. You're spitting them. You want to know the secret of demon? Come on now. In the book of Mark chapter 16 verse 16. Excuse me. In the book of Mark chapter 16 verse 16. Jesus Christ did not tell us to know the secret of demon. What he just said, he said, these signs will follow them that believe. Glory to God. He said, these signs will follow them that believe. In my name, they will cast out devil. Them that believe. Even if you believe today, you just become born again today. In the name of Jesus, you cast out devil. In this day, these signs will follow them that have matured in Christ. Come hear that. It is in this sense we follow them that cannot pray very well. It is in this sense we follow them that cannot preach very well. It is in this sense we follow them that cannot read their Bible and understand it very well. It's good to do all those things. But that is not why the sense will follow you. The sense will follow you because you believe. And because you believe, Christ is in you. And the Bible says Christ in us is the hope of glory. Somebody shout hallelujah. Praise God. So it's the sense that follow you. So you don't need any secrets to cast a devil. The born again man cast a devil. It's not the sense that follow pastor. It's not the sense that follow a prophet. It's not the sense that follow evangelists. It's not the sense that follow teachers. It's not the sense that follow apostle. It's the sense that follow believers. It's not even the sense that follow bishop or pope. No, it's the sense that follow believer. So when I cast a devil, I am not casting a devil because I'm a pastor. In fact, if I'm catching a devil as a pastor, Shame to me. My member should be the one casting a devil. It's a shame at my level. Praise God, by the grace of God, I've been preaching for 10 years now. And my level, I'll be casting a devil by now. It's a shame to me. I will only do that if I don't have member around me. Because when I cast a devil, I will not go cast it out as a pastor. I'm casting a devil as a believer. As a believer. Because I was first a believer before I became a pastor. You must understand that. So when I lay hands on the sick, I'm not even laying on the sick as a pastor. I'm laying hands on the sick as a believer. You say, hey, because he's a pastor, that is where he's healing the sick. You know, many of us think that Jesus Christ, all those miracles he did them as God. No, he was a man like you and I. He came down to this earth as a man. Even though he was God, but he came down to this earth as a man. That was where he went to school. That was where he slept. God does not sleep nor slumber. But Jesus Christ, where he was on this earth, he slept. Jesus Christ was hungry. God not the hungry. God does not go hungry. But Jesus Christ was hungry. To show that he was a man while he was on this earth. And because he was a man, that was where he was a man. He did all those things that he did. In fact, this guy put it like this in the book of Acts, chapter 10, verse 13. He said, "Our God anointed Jesus Christ with the Holy Ghost and with power, who went about doing good, healing all that was sick and was oppressed of the and that were oppressed of the devil." God was only anointing, but he was anointed as a man. And glory to God. The day you become a believer, that same anointing is on you. Praise God. That same anointing. Paul called it, he said, the exceeding greatness of his power. The exceeding greatness of his power, which he wrought towards you. Praise God. He said, it's exceeding greatness of his power. He said, exceeding greatness of his power. He said, that power is in us, which he wrought when he raised Christ from the dead. That same power that raised Christ from the dead is in us today. Praise God. So we do miracles as a man today. Because we have been anointed with that same power that raised Christ from the dead. Somebody, glory to God. So, the preaching that brings about salvation is the message of Jesus. Is the message of Jesus. Let me quickly show you one thing in Luke 24. Luke 24. If you want in Luke 24. La Poshadahaya. Le Kadomaha. Luke 24. Okay. Luke 24, this was after his resurrection. Then it was some guys who were coming from Emmaus. And look at what Jesus Christ said. They were coming after Jesus Christ resurrected. They were complaining, saying, "Oh, we went to his grave, but he's no longer there. We don't know what has happened to his body." They were, they were quarreling. And look at what happened. In verse 25, Jesus Christ said to them, "Say, oh fools and slow of hearts, to believe all that the prophet have spoken. Ought not Christ to have suffered these things and to enter his glory?" So that to say, all that the prophet talked about was about the suffering of Christ and the glory that will follow. Then in verse 46, look at what he said now. He said, "Thus it is written, and thus it is behold, Christ to suffer and to raise from the dead the third day. And that repentance and remission of sin should be preached where? In his name." Take another word. Verse 47, he said, "And that repentance," the word repentance means change of mind. It is Greek word, it's called metanoia, to have a change of mind. Praise God. So when I go to the unbeliever, praise God, or if you are watching me now, you are an unbeliever, have a change of mind that you cannot save yourself. Who save is Jesus. So you have a change of mind that you can't save yourself. Your good works can save you. Thank God for your good works. Praise God. But they can't save you. What brings about salvation is Jesus. Hallelujah. It's Jesus. He said that repentance and remission, the word remission is forgiveness of sins, to be preached in his name among all nations, beginning at Jerusalem. Praise God. So what brings about salvation is the preaching of Jesus. And what is the preaching of Jesus? It's about his death, burial, and resurrection. And repentance. What is that repentance? You know, maybe you always say repentance, if you do bad thing. No, as a Christian, it's not good to do bad thing. But repentance here, it means change your mind. Because a man does not change his mind, that is the man that does evil. So first of all, you have to change your mind from doing evil. Sorry, you have to change your mind that you can't save yourself. You have to change your mind that your good work can't save you, so you can look at the Savior. And when you look at that Savior, it's that Savior that gives you salvation. So, is the preaching of the Savior, who is Jesus Christ, that bring about
salvation.
Praise God. The preaching of Jesus, that is what brings about salvation. It's the preaching of Jesus that is what brings about salvation. So it was not because you were born in church, that is not where you are saved. It's not because you were sick, they lay hands on you, that's not where you are saved. It's not because you're believing God for one miracle and they pray for you that miracle, that's not where you are saved. What brings about salvation is the preaching of Jesus. If I come to you now, I tell you, Demas, your father's ass, I say, come and give a life to Jesus at the end of that message. That salvation is not genuine. Amen. Because you didn't hear about Jesus. If I tell you now, just preach anything. It's not genuine. Praise God. For the purpose of those who you're jumping today, let me go back to Romans, the book of Romans. I read it before the other day, but I will read it again today. I will read it again today. Let us see that book of Romans one more time. You know, if you read from chapter 1, from verse 1 of that Romans, Paul says, brethren, my heart desire and prayer to God for Israel is that they may be saved. So they were not saved. So it was prayed for them that they should be saved. He said, I bear them record that they have a zeal for God, but not according to knowledge. They have a zeal for God. They're going to church, but not according to knowledge. He said, for they are ignorant of God's righteousness, and they are going about to establish their own righteousness. They have not submitted themselves unto the righteousness of God. See that now? They have not submitted themselves unto the righteousness of God. And because they have not submitted themselves to the righteousness of God, they are not saved. They are zealous. They go to church, they fast, they will pray. Praise God. You know, they will give offering. And they will pay their tithe. Praise God. But they are not doing it according to the righteousness of God. Amen. Now, let me jump to verse 10. Or let me take from verse 8. Say, but what's here the word is near in thy, even in thy mouth and in thy heart. That is the word of faith which we preach. Think of that word. The word of faith which we preach. The word of faith which we preach. Verse 7. We say, so then faith come by hearing. Hearing the word of God. The word of God there means the word of Christ. So when you say the word of faith which we preach, it means the word of Christ which we preach. So it's the word of Christ that is being preached. That is what brings about salvation. He said, but what's here this word? The word is named in the mouth, even the heart, even the word of faith which we preach, or the word of Christ which we preach. Now, verse 9 says, if thou shalt confess with the mouth the Lord Jesus and shalt believe in thy heart that God has raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. So you have to believe in your heart and confess with your mouth that Christ raised him from the dead. Hallelujah. Now, look at verse 10. He said, for with the heart man believe unto righteousness. With the heart man believe unto righteousness. Not with your clothes, not with your jewelry, not with your makeup. Praise God. You know, not with what I put on. No, it's with the heart. Praise God. It's with your heart. With the heart man believe unto what? Righteousness. Okay. Kalosha. I say, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. Now look at verse 11 now. He said, for the scripture saith, whosoever believe on him shall not be ashamed. For there is no difference between the Jew and the Greek. For the same Lord over all is rich unto all that call upon him. Now look at verse 13. He said, for whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord, whether the Jews, whether the Gentiles, shall be saved. Remember, the people, anybody that is not from Israel, that is not born again, is a Gentile. Even we, before we became born again, we were Gentile. But the day we became born again, we are no longer Gentile. We are not believers. Glory to God. So that is why I said, for there is no difference whether the Jew or the Gentile. All they need is one Lord and one God, who is Jesus. Now look at verse 13. I say, for whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Good. Now look at the next line. He said, how then shall they call on him in whom they have not believed? So before you call on him, you have to believe. Then he said, how shall they call on him in whom they have not believed? And how shall they believe in whom they have not heard? How can they believe in whom they have not heard? How can they believe in whom they have not heard? How can they believe in whom they have not heard? I take it again. How can they believe in whom they have not heard? You see that now? So the whom is Jesus. So it's the hearing of the whom that brings about salvation. It's the hearing of the it's the hearing of Jesus that bring about salvation, not any other thing. Praise God. Thank God for the other thing. I appreciate it. Praise God. But it's the hearing of the and that is the message he gave us, that repentance and remission of sins should be preached in his name. Because when they don't hear that, how can they believe? They have not heard about him. So how can you believe what we have not heard? It's whom you hear about that you believe. You know, I always make reference to this woman with the issue of blood. That was the Eid. You have to say, this woman, after she heard about Jesus, she said within herself. So there has to be the hearing. It's when you hear about him, faith will now be released in your heart to make up your mind to receive the who is Jesus. So Jesus is the message. Jesus is the salvation. He has paid the price for the whole world. But the truth is that the whole world is not saved. People say the whole world is saved. You know, it's a lie. The whole world is not saved. Hallelujah. He has saved the whole world. The whole world is not saved. That is why we preach. When we preach, when the world received the gospel and the world is saved. Hallelujah. So he died for your sins according to the scripture. He was buried according to the scripture. On the third day, he resurrected according to the scripture. He did not do it for himself. He did it for the whole world. Hallelujah. He did it for the whole world. He did it for me. He did it for you. He did it for the atheist. He did it for the Judaism, the Jewish religion. He did it for the Islam. You know, he did it for the Boko Haram. He did it for everybody. The Bible says, who we have all men to be saved and come to the knowledge of the Son of God. So God wants all men to be saved. Jesus Christ wants all men to be saved so that they will come to his knowledge. Hallelujah. So it's the hearing of Jesus that bring about salvation. The hearing of Jesus that bring about what? Salvation. It's the hearing of Jesus. He said, how can they believe in whom they have not heard? In whom they have not heard. The truth is that, let me tell you the truth, we have many churches today all over the world, especially in Africa, Nigeria, where I come from. But the truth is that it's only few people that have heard about Jesus. So don't ever think that we have enough church and you not preach the gospel again. The truth is that it's only few people that have heard about Jesus. I didn't say there are not many churches. It's only people that have heard about Jesus. Hallelujah. It's only few people that have preached about Jesus. They have heard about demons. They have read about die by fire. They have heard about who stole my garments. They have heard about who stole my wedding gown. They have heard about all sort of nonsense. Praise God. They have heard about sweep their ass. They have heard about all kind of rubbish. You know, but only few people have heard about Jesus. So we cannot attest to that salvation. For there to be the saving of the soul, they have to be in the hearing of Jesus. Because he said, how can they believe in whom they have not heard? How can they believe in whom they have not heard? And in case you are watching me today, or you watch this video later, you are not yet born again. Glory to God. I know you're born again. There's somebody watching me right now. You have stomach pain. You have stomach pain. Lay your hands inside your stomach right now. La koshkadaha ya belenuskaha. Peleskado uyakata baladiana kadoska. Abatosia. I release the power of the resurrection upon that stomach right now. I say be healed right now in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. That stomach pain is gone. It's gone. It's gone. It's gone. It's gone. It's gone. It's gone forevermore in the name of Jesus. It's gone forevermore in the name of Jesus. So it's the preaching of Jesus, like I said, that bring about salvation. In case you are not saved yet, Jesus Christ died for your sins according to the scripture. He was buried according to the scripture and resurrected on the third day according to the scripture. And when you believe this, just confess it wherever you are that Jesus Christ is Lord. I believe that you died for my sins. When you do that, glory to God, you are saved. Hallelujah. So if you have a question and you want to contribute, you are free to call him now, or you are free to call him, or you are free to write the message, or you are free to write your question in the comment box, and I believe I can answer you by the Spirit of God. Thank you, Evangelist Sunday Edos, for joining. God bless you. Thank you, Pastor Mike, for joining. Igberasi, thank you for joining. Igberasi, Bookie. Sunday Kevin, thanks for joining. Apostle Rita Osagi, thanks for joining, man. God bless you. Osaze, thank you for joining, bro. Everyone, Brandy Igberasi, thanks for joining, man. Hope
Peter, thanks for joining. God bless you, man. God bless you. 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 Kelly, MD, my good friend, thanks for joining, bro. Apostle Charles Odigie, thanks for joining, sir. God bless you. Samson Smith, thank you all for joining. Praise God. Thank you for joining. Jesus Christ is Lord. Jesus Christ is Lord. Jesus Christ is Lord. Praise God. He's Lord. He's Lord. Hallelujah. He has risen from the dead. He's Lord. Hallelujah. He's Lord. And his will is that all men should be saved. I want to pray for you right now. If you are sick in your body, or if you are believing God for a miracle, by the supernatural power that raised Christ from the dead, I command, let that miracle take place right now. In any area you need that miracle, in the name of Jesus. There's somebody here, you have pain within your ribs here, close to your leg. I don't know how to play you. Let me just say your ribs, side of your ribs, there is a pain there. There's a pain there. I command that pain to go right now by the power of the Holy Ghost, in the name of Jesus. I command that pain to go right now in the name of Jesus. There's somebody, I don't know, you have pain in your eyes. This particular eye, I think this is left eyes. I command that left eyes to be healed right now, in the name of Jesus. Command that left eye to be healed right now. I come against every kind of disease in that eye. I'm not too good with medical things, but Holy Ghost knows the problem in that eye. I command it to go right now by the power of the Holy Ghost, in the name of Jesus. I command it to go. I command it to go. I command it to go by the power in the name of Jesus. I command it to go. I command it to go. In the name, there's somebody here. You have pains in this, your right hand, your joints here, your joints. This is your joints here. Yes, your joints here. Your joints here. I command that pain to go right now. I command it to go right now. I command it to go right now. Shake your hand. It's gone. It's gone forever. In the name of Jesus. It's gone your right hand. There's somebody here. You have pain in your right, your ankle, your right leg. In the name of Jesus. I cause that pain. I caused it. I caused it. I'll put it by the power that raised Christ from the dead. In the name of Jesus. It's gone forever. 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 Hallelujah. Glory to God. So, like I said, if you are a believer, you ought to rejoice. Don't rejoice because of the material things you have. They are going to perish. Praise God. Rejoice because you have eternal life. Because the joy of the Lord is our strength. I look forward to see you on Sunday evening. I'll come alive on Sunday evening. So, please follow me. Share the video. You can follow me on YouTube also. Pastor Mo Igberesi is my YouTube channel, okay? And I have Instagram account, Pastor Mo Igberesi. I put a lot of messages. You can also follow my brother, Pastor Mike. I think God's Own Evangelical Mission. You see it in the YouTube. And his Facebook account is Iyamu Mike. Also, follow him as you do that. God bless you in the name of Jesus. The knowledge of Jesus Christ is covering the earth as the water covers the sea. Thank you and shalom. Bye. Lekuska.